Hey guys, welcome back to the number. Is it no? Hey guys, welcome back to the number one channel for exploring podiatry. My name is Yona. I'm a third year podiatric medical student at CSPM, and today we're going to be answering the $1 million question, and that is, how long should you shadow podiatrists for? And the simple and plain answer to that is your own personal preference. Yep, you heard it. No such thing of a magic formula for how long you should actually shadow a podiatrist for. Doesn't matter if it's days, weeks, months, years. Okay, that sounds ridiculous. Don't do years. Maybe you can, but don't. Okay. Why I say that is shadowing is supposed to help you answer the most underlying question, and that is, why podiatry? Why do you want to enter this incredible field? And you need to have this question in the back of your mind while you're shadowing. This is an issue that a lot of students forget to answer as they're going through their shadowing experience. And this is why it's very subjective, you know? You have to go into your shadowing experience with a very open mindset and have a bunch of questions to ask the podiatrist as they're going through their daily routine. Don't hesitate to ask a bunch of questions to your podiatrist. They were willing to have you come along for their shadowing experience, and it's a privilege, and they would love for you to ask them a lot of questions for them to help you get into podiatric medical school without having any fear that this was the right profession for you. I don't want you guys to be in the situation where you're 3 years into podiatric medical school and you realize this was not the profession for you. You are $200,000 in debt and you wasted all this time, and now there is no plan B. You do not want to find yourself there. Also, shadowing is crucial for your application process as well as the interview process. Look, when admissions officers invite you for the interview, 99% of the time they're going to ask you the simple question, why podiatry? And this is why shadowing will help you develop that honest answer to give to them the day of that interview. Also, when you're writing your personal statement, we also get this question a lot, and that is, how do you connect podiatry, personal life, and medicine all together? And we usually like to say, did you shadow? Because shadowing helps fill those gaps. Shadowing helps make those connections for you to write an awesome personal statement. Again, there is no magic formula for how long you should shadow a podiatrist for. I'm just gonna give you my personal experience. I shadowed two podiatrists for 3 months, and I had the time to do that. And I felt that was an adequate amount of time for me to feel like this was definitely a field that I really wanted to join. But again, for some of you, you probably don't have the time, and maybe for some of you, 3 days is an adequate amount of time. It all depends on your personal preferences and what your schedule looks like. Hopefully this video has been helpful for you guys. I enjoyed making this video. And if you guys have any more questions, feel free to follow us on Instagram at the DPM Journey and email us the question at the DPM Journey at gmail.com. Also, please hit the subscribe button down below and the bell notification for future videos that will help you during your application process as well as during your podiatric medical school career. Hopefully you guys stay safe out there, and I hope you guys have a great day. Pod Squad signing out. Take care, guys.